Welcome to lectures on Transportation Engineering 2, CE 4 treatment. Today we will learn about traffic flow fundamentals. So, the traffic flow is usually classified into two categories, that is uninterrupted flow and another one is interrupted flow. So, we will see first what is uninterrupted flow. The flow occurring at the long section of the road where the vehicles are not required to stop by any cause or external to the traffic stream. Means suppose if the vehicles are coming on a road junction and some other kind of passages like intersections or interchanges are provided so that the vehicles are not required to stop to cross that road junction, and that kind of facility is called the uninterrupted traffic. So that's what we are discussing here, that is the flow occurring at long section where the vehicles are not supposed to stop due to any other reasons, and they can flow and they can float on their road without any interruption. That kind of flow is called uninterrupted flow. Why? The opposite of this one will be called the interrupted flow. The flow we have on the road junction, that is where the vehicles are stopped by the signals to cross the road junction. That kind of flow is called the interrupted flow, that is the flow occurring at the long section of the road where the vehicles are required to stop by any cause outside the traffic stream, such as traffic signs, traffic signals, traffic lights. That kind of flow is called the interrupted traffic flow. In this uninterrupted flow, we will discuss three parameters, that is number one is flow rate or volume, then is speed, and last one is density or the concentration. So the first one is flow rate or the volume, that is sometimes we call the traffic flow or the traffic volume. What is the traffic volume? Suppose we take the example of this road. Suppose this is the road section, this is a particular point, then what will be traffic flow? The number of vehicles passing from this particular road sections at a over a specified duration of time. Let's say the duration of time is 1 hour. The number of vehicles passing from this particular road section in a duration of 1 hour will be the traffic flow or the traffic volume for this road section. So what is the traffic volume? It is the number of vehicles. It is the number of vehicles passing a particular point on a road section during a specific period of time. We are taking the specific period of time as 1 hour, then the number of vehicles passing on this road in this duration 1 hour from this particular point will be the traffic volume. And how the traffic volume will be represented? The unit for traffic volume will be the vehicle per hour. This is the unit for traffic volume. That means the number of vehicles passing on a particular road section in a duration of 1 hour. The traffic volume can be represented as the vehicle per day, vehicle per minute also. There are different units in a specific duration of time. The time can be defined as defined in terms of hours, in terms of minutes, in terms of day. So if you are representing the number of vehicles passing in particular minute, then the vehicle per minute, if you are representing it in terms of hour, then vehicle per hour in terms of day, then it will be the vehicle per day. So we can say that the traffic volume is expressed as the Q equals to N by T, where N, Q is the flow rate, or to say the traffic volume, it is represented as N vehicle per minute or vehicle per day, or sometimes it is vehicle per hour also. The N is number of vehicles, and then T is the observation period. Here one more term, that is called the capacity. What is the capacity? It is nothing but it is the maximum traffic flow. Means what it will be? The maximum, if suppose this is a road, this is a particular road section, then the maximum number of vehicles. What will be the capacity? It will mean the maximum traffic flow. That means the maximum number of vehicles that can cross this particular road section over a given specific period of time. This specific period of time can be ending, it can be 1 hour. Then what will be the capacity? It will be the maximum number of vehicles that can pass this particular road section over a period of 1 hour. That will be the capacity of this road. That means the capacity is nothing but it is the maximum traffic flow. Therefore, the unit for the capacity will also be the vehicles per hour.
Time headway, the time, again we will take an example of road.
time headway is nothing but the time gap between two successive vehicles. Suppose this is a vehicle, this is another vehicle, time gap between these two vehicles, this is a particular cross section, one vehicle is passed, this cross section, another vehicle passed this particular cross section, the time gap between these two. The time gap between these two vehicles will represent the time headway. The time headway generally we write it as 1 by q. That means what is time headway? This is what is time headway? This is nothing but the time gap between two successive vehicles. That is what the time headway will be, right? The time headway as reciprocal of the traffic volume, that is traffic flow, that is t equals to 1 by q. We know that q is nothing but the traffic flow. What is the unit for flow? It is the vehicle per hour. If this is vehicle per hour, what will be the time headway? The unit for time headway will be hour per volume. And here the spacing. What is the spacing? This is nothing but the distance between it is nothing but the bumper to bumper distance between two vehicles. This is the road, this is one vehicle. Then you can say this bumper to bumper distance between two vehicles, this will be nothing but the spacing. Or sometimes we can write it as like this also. Bumper to bumper distance from the bumper to bumper distance of two successive vehicles is called the spacing between those two vehicles. The spacing is nothing. The spacing we can write the spacing as s equals to 1 by k, where k is nothing but the density. We know that the formula for density, k is nothing but the unit for the density is what? The vehicle per kilometer. So for the spacing, it will be kilometer per vehicle. Here we will learn something about the capacity first. We can write the relation between K and S as K equals to followed by S, where the S will be in meters. So here we will learn about some of the capacity. What we have learned about the capacity? The capacity is nothing but the maximum traffic flow. Here we will try to develop a relation between Q, that is traffic flow, K, that is density, and V, that is the speed. We know that the unit of the Q, that is flow, is the vehicle per hour, while the unit for density is nothing but vehicle per kilometer, and the unit for the speed is kilometer per hour. So if I see these three, if I take, I can see that if I take the multiplication of these two, that is density and speed, I'll get the flow. How? That is, I can write from this that Q equals to nothing but the KV. Because you can see that the unit for K is what? The vehicle per kilometer. Right? The speed of the unit for speed is kilometer per hour. If I do this, kilometer to kilometer we get cancelled, and I'll get the vehicle per hour. That is what the unit of Q. That means the Q is nothing but it is multiplication of density and the speed. As we are saying that Q is nothing but KV, I can write the maximum flow. That is the capacity. First moment equals to at the place of K, 1000 by S into V. Or you say 1000 V by S, this is the formula for the capacity. Here the capacity is also divided into two more. It is also further classified as
yeah.
that is basic capacity, and the second one Indeed, talking side is friends, this is the land of the people and this is the land of Israel. So, what we are talking right now, we are talking about the design capacity. So again, what is the spacing for this? The formula for spacing will depend on, this will be the summation of stopping side distance plus the length of vehicle. Where what will be the SSD? The SSD will be nothing but again the summation of length distance plus braking distance. So here what will be the length distance? This will be VT plus V square divided by 2DF. Where the SSD will be in meter, here it will keep V in meter per second and T in second. We want to keep the V directly in amperes and T second and want to get SSD in meter, then the formula will be 0.278 VT plus V square divided by 254 F, where the V is in amperes. Then what is T? T is nothing but the reaction time of driver. The reaction time of driver will be 2.5 seconds. As this is a normal driver, for a normal driver the reaction time is 2.5 seconds. So as we get SSD, when we take the summation of length of the vehicle plus SSD, this will give the spacing for this physical capacity.
Meter, this is the spacing
So now we need to calculate the capacity. What is the formula for capacity? This will be C equals to 1000 V by S. 1000 into V is given as 65 MPa, while we got the spacing as 91.65. If we calculate it, we will get this capacity as 710 vehicle per hour. Reaction time of travel was given, length of vehicle was given, and the coefficient of pressure F was given, and we were asked to calculate the capacity. So what we did, first of all, as nothing was mentioned, we assumed it for the practical capacity, and we solved it for, first of all, for SSD, as Vt plus V square divided by 2Z, and as we got SSD, we took the summation of SSD plus length of the vehicle, so we got this spacing, and once we got this spacing, we can calculate the capacity, that is 1000 V by S. So we were, the value was of V is already given, and we already solved in the problem this value of spacing. Once we will put the value, we will get the capacity. Let's see some of the numerical. What is given in this equation? On a highway, the velocity of vehicle is given as 40 km/h. The stopping distance is directly given as 20 m. The length of the rated wheel base is 6 m, and we determine the traffic flow. We are asked to calculate the Q. What is given first of all? We will write the given data. The first thing what is given is the velocity V equals to km/h, then the stopping distance directly given as 20 m, then the length of rated vehicle L is given as 6 m, and we are asked to calculate the traffic flow. So directly we will calculate the spacing first. The spacing we know that FST plus L, and the stopping distance is directly given as 20 m is the problem. So 20 plus length of vehicle is 6 m, so it will be 26 m. This is the spacing. And once we got displacing, we know that the formula for flow, that is Q, is 1000 V by S, 1000 into V is 40 km/h given, divided by displacing. What is displacing? Displacing is 26 m. Once we calculate this, we will get the traffic flow as 1.38. Vehicle per hour. This is the flow for this vertical problem. What was given in the question? In the question, it was given that on a highway, if the velocity of vehicle is 40 km/h, the velocity of the vehicle was given. The velocity of the vehicle was given, and the stopping distance was given directly in this problem. That is 20 m, and the length of vehicle is given as 6 m. We are asked to determine the traffic flow. So what we have done, we know that spacing is nothing but it is the summation of stopping by distance plus length of wheel base. And fortunately here, all the values are given directly in the problem. So we will take the summation of both. What is the stopping by distance is 20 m, while the length of the wheel base is given as 6 m. We took the summation and directly we got spacing as 26 m. Then, now we are asked to find out the traffic flow. We know that Q as traffic flow, this can be the equation for this, can be written as 1000 V by S. Where the value of L means nothing but the velocity, S is nothing but displacing. Displacing we have already calculated, and the value of velocity is given. So we will put both the values and we will get the traffic flow. And this is, as we have solved it, we get 1.38 vehicle per hour. Now let's see what the model that is known as Green-Hegel model for the linear relationship between the URK and B.
Minus
UF by KJ into K. In the place of K, we will write U by U. Now we want to get this equation in terms of Q equals to. So what we have to rearrange the terms. I'll keep this term this side. UF by KJ into Q by U equals to UF minus U. What I have done? I have taken this term as U minus UF. And I have also multiplied both the sides equation by minus 1. So we will get it UF minus U. So Q will be, from here the Q will be UF minus U divided by UF into KJ dot U. When solving, this term can be written as 1 minus U by UF into KJ into U. So this will be written as KJ dot U minus this term KJ U directly. Now this term KJ into U will be multiplied with this term U by UF, so it will be KJ divided by UF into U square. Let's call this as equation number 2. Now we have to apply the boundary equation for getting the maximum flow. What are the boundary term conditions for maximum flow? That the flow will be 0 above 0 density, flow will be 0 above maximum density, and dQ divided by dU must be equal to 0. dQ divided by dQ by dK must be equal to 0. What are the boundary conditions? What we will apply here? That dQ divided by dQ by dK must be 0 and dQ by dU must be equal to 0. Here this is the equation. This equation is in terms of k square of Q. So we will differentiate this equation number A, and from here we will try to get the dQ by dK for maximum flow. So from here, dQ divided by dK, this term will be minus 2 into UF by KJ K only plus UF. This must be equal to 0 for maximum traffic flow. So if we solve this, we will get it. That K equals to KJ by 2. Similarly, from equation number, let's call this equation number B. Similarly, from equation number B, we will differentiate this also with respect to U. So what will do dQ by dU? It will be KJ minus 2u KJ by UF, and this must be equal to 0 for maximum flow. So if we solve this, from here also we will get U equals to UF by 2. We know that the relation between QK and U is what? Q equals to KU. We have already discussed this one, that is Q equals to KU. So for maximum flow, what will be Q max? Will be at the place for maximum flow, K is nothing but the KJ by 2, and speed is nothing but the UF by 2. So Q max will be from here
AJ into UF divided by 4. Like AJ is nothing but the gen density and UF is nothing but the mean free speed. This is what the green chain model, which gives the relation in between the gen density, free mean speed and the maximum flow. This is the linear relationship among all. So in today's lecture we have seen the types of traffic flow, that is uninterrupted traffic flow, then interrupted traffic flow. Then we learn about the various definitions like the capacity, traffic flow, what is density, then what is speed, time headway, space headway, then types of capacity, practical capacity, basic capacity. We have seen the limits also on that, and then we have started with this linear relationship, or instead this model, that is green chain model. So this is what we have learned in today's lecture. Thank you.